I was selected by my peers and have the privilege to speak on behalf of this beautiful cohort to share a few of our collective insights. When I think back to the first time we all met and our first few workshops, I remember thinking to myself, wow, what a diverse pool of people, experiences, expertise, backgrounds, and reasons for applying to SELP. It was hard for me to imagine at the time how this program could tackle everyone's needs and how we would bond as a cohort. As you have heard today, our class has a lot of passion, vision, and commitment to this agency in an impactful way. This unites us. We share a desire to contribute to this agency. As a class, we didn't always see things the same way. However, over the next few minutes, I want to present the insights that we do share. Eleanor Roosevelt once said, "The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams." The image on the screen is an artist's vision of astronauts exploring the surface of the moon back in 2005. Today, we are making this artist's dreams a reality. Let's fast forward to 2021 to the NASA Innovative Advanced Concepts Program Symposium to get a glimpse of what dreamers today see for the future of this agency. Our cohort has invested the last year in becoming better leaders and advocates to NASA's future. As we graduate, our desire is to make these dreams a reality. With that in mind, I will present our perspectives in three areas: driving NASA's future direction, enhancing NASA's work environment, and developing NASA's leaders. As Andy mentioned, we had the opportunity to benchmark Rear Admiral Shoshana Shatfield, from President of the Naval War College, and Rebecca Gray from NBC Universal Comcast. They reminded us that NASA represents the hopes and dreams of humanity. We sometimes forget that NASA has a truly compelling vision that inspires people inside and outside of the agency. Our leadership coach, Cindy Sook, constantly focused on the power of being intentional and acting with purpose. The phrase, "so that," is engraved in our heads, reminding us to focus on the why. We've learned the importance of creating a shared vision to mobilize teams, programs, and entire organizations. On our own initiative, some of us visited White Sands Testing Facility to explore the capabilities and their expertise. One of our classmates asked the different subject matter experts that we met, "How connected do you feel to NASA's mission?" The responses vary from barely to very connected. In our day-to-day work, we often get fixated on inputs and outputs, schedules and reviews, and we lose sight of the bigger picture. As NASA is changing and continues to expand working with commercial partners, it is vitally important to find ways to be intentional about how we operate. Something as simple as connecting the dots so people on projects can see how their contribution adds up to a bigger purpose. More work is needed to communicate and build ownership in our mission, vision, and the goals at all levels of our workforce. We talked about transformation and change in SELP. We learn about the life cycle model and how to manage crucial conversations. As leaders, we need to own what was done in the past, envision and plan how we will evolve the path forward, and clearly define and communicate the role our agency will have in the future. We must have the courage to move to the next level. Change is hard and it is inevitable. As leaders, it is our job to guide the workforce through change. In our workshops, we learned the power and importance of effective endings to set up for the future. This is a tough task that people and organizations don't do well. We can't be afraid to have the difficult conversations that are part of moving through endings. Before moving to the next topic, I want to end this segment on a high note. As we move to a hybrid environment, we can use this opportunity to fully anchor our One NASA vision across the whole agency and with our partners. We can be amazing as an integrated team. We can work together to retain our technical capabilities, to stay relevant in a changing environment, to be champions of NASA's project portfolio and vision. If we truly share available resources across the agency and remove the barriers to make cross-center collaboration easy, imagine what we could do with all of us pulling together as one team. With the possibility of a strong agency direction and ownership at all levels, let's turn our attention to the second topic, our work environment. COVID has already forced us to change how we do work. In SELP, we had the opportunity to embrace new roles, whether that was at our home centers or at our timing centers. We did this in a hybrid or mostly virtual environment. Some of us experienced at first hand the isolation a person can feel when you join a new team, especially one that is virtual. As leaders, we will need to be more intentional about how we onboard and integrate a team member in this new hybrid environment. During my SELP assignment, I was privileged to support the Europa Clipper project at JPL. Their motto was, we either succeed together or we fail together. I was impressed with the way people reached out to help each other across shifts. The Clipper team provided tools to help employees share knowledge and provide support to each other. NASA knowledge needs to be easily shared among and across our workforce. Our cohort believes that this should be a high priority to enable collaboration across the agency and with external partners. As we move into a hybrid environment and the water cooler chatter gets quieter, now more than ever, it is important to create a connected workplace. Leaders need to create work environments where employees feel comfortable sharing ideas and feel included and respected. This is essential for engagement, retention, productivity, and overall motivation. All of our SELP workshops were virtual, and the SELP program team created a safe space to help us feel connected. We share our life journeys, we participated in virtual dinners, we did activities that pushed us to be vulnerable and connect on a personal level. We bonded quickly, and those bonds grew bigger and bigger with each workshop. As a result, whenever any of us traveled to the same city, whether that was for personal or work-related reasons, we jumped at the opportunity to meet in person. Getting to know each other as people helps employees feel more invested in their roles and in NASA's mission. Let's look at the other side of the coin. One classmate described their home center as a non-inclusive environment where employees were treated like property and lacked the human side to management. During their SELP assignment, this person had a very different experience. A work environment that was inclusive, where management empowered their employees and made them feel valued. Switching centers or projects should not be the solution. As leaders, we should provide a positive workforce at all NASA centers. To support this, NASA policies, training, and incentives for supervisors and managers should focus on the importance of being intentional about connecting with employees on a personal level and encouraging open communication, respect, recognition, and trust. We want to continue to be an agency with the highest workforce satisfaction and one that attracts and retains the best talent. A few final thoughts about the work environment. Collaboration and teamwork are key for NASA's mission success. Positive, respectful relationships make it easier for teams to have successful and difficult conversations, and for employees to feel empowered and included. Our experience in SELP gave us tools and showed us the value of building personal connections based on authenticity, vulnerability. This is key to growing a cohesive team. The first two topics I discuss are directly shaped and impacted by how leaders operate at all levels.
This leads to the importance of the third topic, developing NASA's leaders. Great leaders are not born, they are made. It is imperative for NASA to invest in developing leaders so that we can drive the agency's future direction and create the right work environment to enable our workforce to expand the boundaries of technology, science, and space exploration.
Our cohort has learned valuable leadership skills and tools to lead program and projects, manage change, collaborate with others, and guide teams to achieve NASA's vision. These concepts and tools should be brought to a wider audience across the agency. This could be done by increasing the size of the cohort, by running more cohorts in parallel, by opening SELP to workforce beyond engineering community, or by standalone workshops for future leaders. We are avid advocates for the need to continue to use SELP to provide agency cross-center interaction. There is a tremendous value to SELP assignments at different centers. Because participation in SELP is limited, we recommend finding ways to provide a coherent structure for center level programs that mirror leadership workshops. NASA's workforce is aging, and we are seeing leaders begin to retire in increasing numbers. Developing the next generation of NASA's leaders at all levels should be a high priority. In closing, as we hold in our hands the hopes and dreams of humanity, it is our responsibility to prepare today to carry those dreams carefully into the future of NASA and make them a reality. Our cohort has invested in the future of the agency. It is with the best intentions that we offer these insights and perspective to some of the challenges facing our agency. Leverage us to be a conduit of communications for NASA's future, to be advocates for creating a constructive change for the agency that we so much love. Together, we stand committed to this extraordinary mission and success. Thank you.